Once again, thank you, John.
Thank you very much for your kindness and for the invitation to talk about our experiences in teaching Industry 4.0 and its enabling technologies, including metrology for digital transformation. As you said, our Institute for Industrial Quality was created by agreement between INTI and UNSAM in 1995. So we are 26 years old now. And the creation of our institute was intended to face the quality paradigm at that time. We operate in the headquarters of INTI. This is our building, but we use all the infrastructure of these 26 hectares in Buenos Aires belonging to INTI, and the university is here very, very close to INTI. That's the reason why it was selected this university for such an agreement. The main scheme of our teaching purposes relies on the letters MMPQ, which is a German scheme where M means metrology, N normalization or standardization, P comes from testing, and the Q from quality, but quality in the sense of quality assurance at the industrial level, where everything has to be tested in different steps during the production processes according to certain standards, and these always imply measurements. So we teach metrology within all these contexts, and that's the reason why our audience is much more broad than only metrologists. Excuse me. So in Argentina, there are three kinds of post-graduation titles. They are specialization, master, and doctor. We cover specialization in industrial quality, specialization in the industrial quality in foods. These specializations take 2 years to cover, and we include the MMPQ contents recently explained, plus quality management according to the certification scheme of the German quality for German company for quality. So besides this title, the students may continue with a master thesis and they get a master degree in industrial quality. At present, some theses are related to Industry 4.0 and its enabling technologies, as I shall refer later. We also have a PhD, a doctorate in quality and industrial innovation. And at present, we have 30 students doing their doctoral thesis. And some of these theses are also related to Industry 4.0 and its enabling technologies. As undergraduate degrees, we have two engineering careers, food engineering and industrial engineering. 6 years long each of the careers. And the particularity of our engineering careers is that we teach a lot of metrology and quality. Introduction to metrology for food engineering and for industrial engineering, we are two more metrology 1 and metrology 2 subjects. We also have some subjects in these engineering careers, including some topics of 4.0, for instance, automation and control, where distant measurements and systems operations is the main subject of automation, but we are adding several elective subjects. This is so because it would take a long time to formalize accredited modifications in engineering careers all over the country, accepted by the government, to be able to include compulsory subjects within Industry 4.0 topics. So we have to offer elective subjects to the students of the last years. So at present, we're introducing the following elective subjects: industrial design management and additive manufacturing, artificial intelligence, industrial IoT and cybersecurity, and advanced robotics. We also offer some courses of 120 hours duration, ending in a diploma, in addition to the undergraduate and postgraduation courses. We offer this possibility to obtain a university diploma. At present, we have two of such training courses, one in quality and integral management of processes, one in for assistance in metrology with quality orientation, another rather new for textile industry processes, and quite new, our diploma in Industry 4.0 and its enabling technologies. So facing this specific education for the new paradigm of Industry 4.0, we begin with an introductory course of 36 hours to Industry 4.0 and its enabling technologies. It can be continued with the diploma recently described, and we are planning for the next year or 2023, a master degree in Industry 4.0 and its enabling technologies. This will take some 600 hours plus the thesis. Concerning the topics covered by this diploma, we have first an introduction to Industry 4.0, then we present a learning factory, I shall refer to this later, industrial automation, IIoT, cloud computing, cybersecurity, big data and analytics, artificial intelligence, augmented reality, additive manufacturing, blockchain. Blockchain will be given by a colleague from Inmetro, Wilson Melo, who is an expert in blockchain and special applications of blockchain to metrology. We also, together with Hector Lice, whom you all know, covers some topics of metrology 4.0 and quality 4.0, and then some classes on simulation, productivity 4.0, and advanced robotics. We also have written some articles, in general articles, explaining that to face the loss of jobs associated with the introduction, with the eruption of Industry 4.0, it is essential to train highly qualified human resources, operators, technicians, and professionals who are inserted throughout the whole production chain. Now, how do we develop the skills demanded in highly automated environments of Industry 4.0, if there are still not many companies where the processes are fully automatized? So that's the challenge. And how do we introduce practical laboratory activities? This is done with a learning factory of Japanese origin, and the product which is produced in this learning factory is a box, a small plastic box or container that is filled and customized with different spheres of different colors. So this is the learning factory which I am referring to, and we are just presenting the learning factory composed of 10 operational stages to our rector of the university, to the president of INTI and some other colleagues, and Professor Mollio, who is in charge of operating the learning factory, and Hector Lais and me. And as said, the small container with the spheres of different colors is first designed for different customers. So we have a customized product. Then we have to fill, after designing, we have to fill the containers with the spheres. And then the next stage is a weighing stage, and then cupping, and then labeling, and then warehousing. Here in this warehouse, the containers are stored and finally dispatched. So this is a system with a lot of PLCs and all the electronics associated to automation, and the students may see how would be a real factory where everything is automatized or partially automatized. The software covers all the pyramid of software for Industry 4.0, from the supervisory control and data acquisition known as SCADA, and especially this so-called MES, this manufacturing execution system. The learning factory has a known education MES and reproduces real situations and the most relevant functions associated with the manufacturing execution management system. We also have another software called 3D Supra, which allows to see a 3D picture of the factory in the screen of the participants at distance. So the student may be 1,000 kilometers distant from the place where the learning factory is installed, and may operate from his own PC, the learning factory, and may test if what he is instructing to the learning factory to do, for instance, to fill the container with 10 grams of yellow spheres and 20 grams of red spheres, really occurs in his own screen. So this interactivity allows a distant learning, very important nowadays, and these courses for getting diplomas described are attended by persons of all over the country and other countries like neighbor countries like Chile, Brazil, or Uruguay also. This question of learning factories is not new. There are some commercial, but there are a lot of universities where people is dedicated to build their own learning factories for different purposes and for different industrial sectors. So this year, for instance, recently took place the 11th international conference on learning factories in Austria. And for the first time, some topics on Industry 4.0 are being covered with learning factories at the international level. We are still awaiting the proceedings. So now the challenge is to go from MMPQ 3.0 to MMPQ 4.0. The standardization for digital technology, testing and quality for digital technology, and of course, metrology for digital technology. This is what we try to cover with the courses which I just described. Now, specifically in teaching metrology for digital technology, we cover the following topics: the digital calibration certificate, metrological clouds, digital twins, distance calibration, etc. Especially, we are interested in integrated metrology, which is very well described in a study done by Catapult at the United Kingdom on integrated metrology. You can get it in the web, or I can provide it to you. And here is very well described the roadmap in the United Kingdom to cover the next 10 years at the industrial level with in-process measurements, in-line measurements, offline measurements, on-machine measurements, and so on. And finally, the new SI, which is said to be more suitable for Industry 4.0, is also taught. In reality, we are teaching the new SI since 2005, accompanying the process at the CIPM, where the discussions were held. And at present, we have also published some papers on educational matters on how to teach the new SIs, and with some critical review on the revised SI. And we also mentioned the wonderful developments achieved at NIST in the so-called NIST on a chip program as examples of how metrological standards can be produced in a very small size, in a reduced size, in order to be incorporated directly in the factories and in the machines themselves. Now, responding to these new challenges for metrology for digital technologies, and we address questions like, for instance, how will the quality infrastructure evolve in the new context of digital transformation? Last week, a master thesis was presented by Gaetan, who is present at this moment in the conference, and the topic he addressed was the impact of digitalization on accreditation processes. Another master thesis presented in June, conducted by Hector Lais, and referred to the integration of data in a multi-platform ecosystem of distributed generation sources on a smart grid with injection of renewable energies. And finally, I want to say that beyond our educational efforts, there are many developments originated beyond NMIs in some universities. And for instance, the laser cooling, which has so many metrological applications, but even some special clocks has been produced at the Paris University and Stanford University, and then later with William Phillips from Nice got the Nobel Prize in 1997. And this was the occasion at Incaline to award to Professor Claude Cohen-Tanoussi from France with the doctor honoris causa in the within the frame of a SIM meeting held at Buenos Aires with the participation of several of the SIM directors at that time, like Umberto Brandis and Claudia Santos and so on. So the role of the universities accompanying the developments of the NMIs is also very important. This is of course not the situation in our university, which is rather new, but this is perhaps the dream that in several of our SIM countries we may have, of course, looking at Nice and JAILA. Well, finally, I would like to say that we also produce educational material for a wider audience. Yeah? For instance, for a TV channel, which is a state cultural channel in Argentina, we produce 13 videos of metrology with a duration of 25 minutes each. And we hope to repeat this experience with new material for awareness rising in questions of 4.0 technologies. We are on the way to do this. The videos related to metrology, which you can download from Canal Encuentro, ask to me, and I leave here the URLs of each of the one of the 13 videos. They are, of course, in Spanish. They refer what is measurement, the history of measurements, the SI, time and frequency, length, units of mass, force, pressure, volume and flux, electricity, temperature, luminous intensity, acoustics, environmental chemistry, food chemistry. And that's all what I wanted to transmit in this talk. And thank you very much for your attention.
No, thanks to you for your presentation. I have to say that I was honored a couple of years ago to visit Incaline and to meet Mr. Dr. Joaquin Valdez in Argentina. And actually what they are doing over there is really great. And they are putting metrology in a higher position than many of our countries. So thanks a lot for what you're doing over there, not just in INTI, but also in Incaline. Okay, we will start now with the round of questions that we have over here. And as usual, I would like to ask the first one. When you were talking about the classes, the different titles that you were giving at the university, one of the first questions that passed through my mind is the following. Are the master degrees and the PhD graduate students that you are graduating from the university being mainly absorbed by INTI, or they are mainly working in the different industries in Argentina?
It's different referring to the master thesis than to the doctoral thesis. The specializations following with the master degree are attended by people coming from outside India and outside the university, from companies and other universities, and they only attend classes twice a week from 18 to 21 because they work during all the time. The theses are done at their own working places. So they have to research in some of the MMPQ questions on how to improve this at their own companies. Now, the doctor thesis are rather new. We started only a couple of years ago. They are done at INTI. So they can be done at another university, and we have some of the 30 doctorants of course working at other places, at other universities, but most of them are working at INTI, not only at the headquarters in Buenos Aires, but maybe at INTI centers in the country. The topics covered have to be of interest for this kind of doctorate, but also for the laboratory, for the INTI laboratory where the thesis has to be done. And INTI pays some fellowships. At present, we have some 20 fellowships issued paid by INTI and transferred to the university. So they are fellowships from INTI and the university. And from the 30 persons doing now their doctoral thesis, between 15 and 20 are paid by INTI. That's the case.
Okay, thanks a lot. Also, following up on that, I'd like to make a comment from Mr. William Guillaume from ENN Chile. He mentioned in that apparently he has been present there, and he says, first, excelente presentación and also excellent diploma in Industry 4.0. So congratulations on that one. One of the questions that also we have is, how many students can you attend at this moment? Can you have at the university? And following that one, I would like to ask if the classes that you are being offered are face-to-face classes, or now you have also evolved to the virtual environment with the pandemic?
Well, the university on SAM has around 20,000 students, but our institute is like a small faculty of the university operating within INTI. It's not the only one. There are others operating, for instance, at the Atomic Energy Commission and so on. But we have some 200 students studying engineering and some 50 students doing specializations and some 5 to 10 master theses are produced per year. Now, concerning the all this is normally going in presence at the university, at INTI itself, but during the pandemic, we are operating in a virtual way, like many others, of course. Now, concerning the new diploma for Industry 4.0 and the introductory course first. The introductory course was attended by 300 colleagues, 150 of them belonging to INTI and 150 belonging to different companies or other universities outside our own stage. And the diploma is on the way now. It's attended by 150 persons, 50 from INTI and 100 from outside. I don't know if there was another question. This was the first question.
That was basically it. And I would like also, we also have another question that I would like to ask you is related to NMI and Industry 4.0. The question will be, which do you consider could be the best NMI strategy? One, to wait for an increasing demand on metrology 4.0 from the industry, or as the opposite, to develop upfront the competences to attend this industry, such as infrastructure, services, human resources, etc. Which one do you consider is the best approach in this case?
There is no time for waiting. Industry 4.0 is here. It's a challenge for us to be at the front of the implications of the loss of jobs that will produce the
automation,
the invasion of robots and automatization processes in many, many industrial sectors. This has been studied and quantified, and there is no time to wait. So there is no time to wait for a new engineering career. Imagine you want to launch an engineering different from industrial engineering, mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, and you want to launch an engineering for Industry 4.0. So, first, it has to be authorized by the educational authorities of each country, and this takes several years. And then you begin, and the first engineers will end their studies 6 or 7 years later. So if you want to begin now, from the very beginning, you will get the first Industry 4.0 engineers in 10 or 15 years more. So there is only a way to introduce teaching processes in what it is, in what we have at present. And concerning research work, in my opinion, we should focus what will be really applied and use the existing infrastructure, the metrological clouds and other clouds, not necessarily metrological clouds, but you have to use Google for artificial intelligence, for instance. And there is no time to weigh what should we do in the next future. It's time to begin with.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Joaquin. I think we can close the presentation with this thought. There is no more time to wait. We should be there in front, right? So thanks a lot for your presentation. Thank you, Mr. Joaquin.
So
a pleasure to have you over here. And thanks for answering all these questions. And we also know that we have now in Argentina also a place that we can study, we can better up our knowledge in terms of metrology.